Take it easy.
The strength of the fortifications remains unknown. Your foes.
Whoa!
You fight them for the good of the duchy. Captain de la Torre will give you the details.
Go, go.
Roderick's men are not to be.
Come on.
Geralt, good you're here. Ready to attack Duntine?
See, you already prepared a plan. Walk me through it.
We have two objectives. To find Her Illustrious Highness's sister and capture the man who blackmailed the vampire. Duntine is a modest complex. Several old buildings, a high wall around them. At the center of the enclosure stands an imposing keep. Restored not long past by the elderly knight of the castle, Roderick. We mean to strike here, through the main gate, then secure the area in front of the keep by storm.
How many men defend Duntine, you know?
Roderick maintains a team of knights for defense. They are no army, but they could number several dozen. Also, Roderick recently took in a band of foreign mercenaries. About them, we know very little.
Need to hit them from both sides. You draw the defenders, keep them busy. I'll sneak in the back way, find the women, make sure they come to no harm. I'll vault over the wall as soon as you start your assault.
Your plan puts you at great risk, but I sense you will handle it well. Let us go.
So it begins.
Quick! We grab Roderick's horses and we bolt.
We won't bolt far if the boys out front don't hold.
Not so fast. Little change of plans.
Kill him!
Roderick sent them to get the horses.
I see no ducals along the road.
They must not be guarding it.
Roderick was right. We can flee. We'll manage.
But be careful if you drop any. That's almost the lot. We shall be ready to go soon. Somebody else, if we don't let it.
Show you, rogue!
mercy! I did no wrong!
Nah, kept the wrong damn company. Centrion's men, where are they?
I knew. Shouldn't have let them under my roof.
Where are they now?
In the keep, ready in their escape.
There's someone with them? Woman named Sianna?
Of course. She convinced me to let them in.
And a whole pile of trouble along with them. Where is she?
Packing. We were to leave together. An old fool. I'd have done anything for her.
Where is she? In the keep too?
Yes. Her chamber is in the tower. The top floor.
Where's the hostage? The woman?
What do you mean? I know nothing about a hostage. Must be the handiwork of my guests.
What will become of me?
Here, press it against the wound. Should staunch the bleeding.
I thank you.
Giving you one last chance. Yield.
The dead harlot got us into this. Kill him! Attack!
Could use our help. So, Witcher, this is no time to explain. Where is Renna?
Expect to answer a lot of questions inside.
Let us go then. Are you hurt? If any of them.
You know me. I'd never let them hurt me. I just waited for you to come.
I didn't know where to look. They threatened to kill you. Forgive me. I failed you.
Now we need only find Anna Henrietta's sister. Where should we look? Do you know?
Mm-hmm. Ran into Roderick, Duntine's lord. Told me where I'd find Sianna.
Then speak and let's grab her. Time is short.
Said she was in a room, in the tower. Very one we're in right now. Which, incidentally, looks nothing like a prison cell. And just so happens there's a carafe full of wine here. Bet it's stolen Saint Real.
What's your point?
Stop playing dumb. I know everything. Your plan, that this was part of it.
Witcher, what is this?
Sorry, Dedlof. You've been had.
My friend, please. You must listen to what Geralt has to say.
Never was any abduction. She faked it to be able to control you, manipulate you.
You lie! He seeks to turn us against each other!
Let him speak.
Blackmailers? Pure fiction. She planned everything. You killed all those men at her behest.
That is impossible.
Sorry, Dedlof. She used you. Part of her plan.
If you do not, I will raise Beauclair to the ground. This I promise you. You've 3 days. I shall be waiting.
He just fly off?
He did not wish to act rashly. He's gone to soothe his nerves.
Think he'll do it? Make good on his threat?
I cannot say. He can be unpredictable when fury consumes him.
I shall go to him.
Come again? After what he just...
You don't know Dedlof like I do. If I don't do as he says, he truly will destroy the city. He's more than capable of it.
Conscience gets to you now?
Better late than never, right?
Well, it truly does seem the best option.
Your Grace, we must proceed with caution. Guardsmen saw vampires here. They could still be about.
Vampires or no vampires, my sister is here. Find her.
Your Grace, that...
Sianna, it's true. It's you. Sister dear, what have you gotten yourself into? So concerned, I'm surprised. Is there an ounce of truth to it? You feel resentment. I understand. But I promise we shall work through all the unfortunate matters of the past. We will discuss them later. Captain, escort Sianna to the palace. I shall meet with her as soon as we return.
As you wish, Your Grace.
And you, Witcher. You have my thanks. I cannot believe my sister was so near the whole time. Roderick of Duntine shall answer for treason and blackmail.
Roderick got duped and used, just like the vampire.
Apropos, were you able to establish who kidnapped his beloved?
We've discovered Sianna blackmailed the vampire, ordered him to kill those men.
What? What nonsense is this?
She is his missing lover. Staged her own abduction to force him to do her bidding.
He was a tool. Whole scheme was Sianna's. She was behind it.
You're mistaken. You must be. This cannot be true.
Your Grace, I know this vampire and...
What? You know him? Who is he?
Detlaf.
Same who so recently sat at my table and told me of Nazer. Is there anything else you've neglected to mention? A dragon living beneath Mount Gorgon, perhaps? Is anyone else here a vampire? Where is he now?
Waiting for Sianna. If she doesn't show up to meet him by an appointed time, he'll destroy Beauclair.
He dares threaten us?
Your Grace, we have 3 days to bring him Sianna and...
Not a word. You have 3 days to bring me his head. No more secrets. No more helping vampires. I want what I'm paying for. The head of the beast.
Do you think Her Grace's nerves have been calmed?
Doubt it. Rarely forgets, rarely retracts what she says, especially not threats.
Yes, well, even I must admit Detlaf's actions were highly inappropriate. Reprehensible, even. Are you upset?
Why would I be?
Let's see. You're returning from your hunt empty-handed. No trophy. No new lead to boast of, then pursue.
Upset's just not a sensation I feel. Ever. Mutations, remember?
Yes, of course. The excuse you resort to whenever you'd rather not talk about something.
Observant of you. So let's change the subject.
How do your employers customarily react when you fail to meet their expectations?
Depends. Peasants cuss me out. Merchants demand I refund their deposit, whereas nobles mostly just release their hounds.
And rulers?
Usually threaten me with the gallows.
Her most illustrious grace awaits the gentleman.
Your Grace, the population demands she be punished. Sianna's committed terrible crimes. Spilt so much blood. They...
Another word, Palmerin, and I shall spill even more blood. Yours. I repeat for the last time. Sianna is responsible for the death of many. True. But she is also my sister. We are bound by blood and by a shared childhood. I shall not allow her to be lynched.
Your Grace, I fear the masses might rise. Storm the prison. Pitchforks and torches in hand.
Let them storm. They will not find her there. Sianna is hidden away in a safe place. She shall await trial there until we have rid ourselves of this accursed vampire. Which, to judge by your means, has not yet come to pass.
Did what we could, but...
My patience is at an end, Geralt. Where is he? Where is Detlaf?
Don't know. I lost his trail.
Is this all you have to say?
I respect your grace. All I can say is the truth.
Ah. At times, I hunt foxes. Do you know how it works? The ducal huntsman releases the hounds. They catch the fox's scent, chase the animal down, and lead the battue to it. All within an hour. You, Witcher, have had a week. The aid of my most excellent knights. Yet, you have tracked absolutely nothing down. I've begun to suspect my beagles might have done a better job.
Allow me to point out certain subtle but essential differences between a higher vampire and a fox, or game in general.
Truly. Like the ones between a pathetic quip and a treasonous offense. Watch your words, Witcher. But to the matter at hand. Have you managed to establish anything?
Your Grace, it seems Sianna tricked Detlaf, used him to murder the knights who escorted her into exile. We have reason to believe that...
Your Grace! Vampires!
What? Speak now!
Vampires! They protect the city! Kept the Nullator defense to square near the boat landing, but... So many lives lost!
Damn it.
If it's war this Detlaf wants, it's war he shall have. Geralt, get to work. This time I'll hear no excuses. Palmer and you...
Get her out of here.
Sianna failed to appear as summoned. And there. Detlaf is not making idle threats.
Seems not. Need to make some serious plans of our own now. It's gone too far, dammit. Regis, you mentioned there was a way to draw Detlaf out. A way you've avoided resorting to so far because you thought it was too dangerous.
Is that how I put it? Do forgive me, and I've misled you terribly. The word dangerous is simply a scandalous understatement in this case.
Regis... Another inner monologue growing out of a personal dilemma. Just tell me how to flush Detlaf out. Force him to meet. Please.
In due course. But first, Geralt, I'd like you to consider the alternative. After all, you could fulfill Detlaf's demand and liberate his beloved Sianna.
Think Detlaf still believes Sianna's innocent?
I believe he suspects something. He must. And he seeks to understand what happened.
And for that, he's declared war on the entire duchy?
What can I say? Moderation was never his strong suit.
Think Detlaf still believes Sianna's innocent?
I believe he suspects something. He must. And he seeks to understand what happened.
And for that, he's declared war on the entire duchy?
What can I say? Moderation was never his strong suit.
Really want to free Sianna? Hand her over to Detlaf? Refuse to accept you consider that wise.
It's hard to believe, I know. But Detlaf is not actually evil, merely impulsive. He needs but meet with her, speak with her, and he will spare the city.
So say I agree to this, because I might. Still no chance Anna Henrietta will.
I do not recall ever suggesting we ask her permission.
What if it's nothing like you say? What if it goes sour, ends in a fight? Willing to guarantee Sianna won't get hurt?
It seems unlikely in the extreme, but...
Didn't ask for a lecture on probability. Need a simple answer. Yes or no.
I vow that not a hair on her head shall come to any harm.
Got serious reservations about this plan. Not least among them, we have no idea where Sianna's being held. You heard the Duchess. She's not at the prison.
Hardly a reservation.
More of an excuse? I'm certain you'll find her. You must merely decide you wish to.
Could ask Damien. Duchess treats him like a lapdog, keeps him close most times. He might know something more.
There, you see? I knew you'd think of something. Bravo. I trust I've dispelled your doubts, then.
Not so fast. We're not done talking. How would I go about luring Detlaff out of hiding if I wanted to? With the blood of a virgin?
You see, somewhere nearby lives an unusual denizen. One of the unseen. Ancient and powerful vampires. Among the oldest and strongest.
And?
Tusa is this unseen elder's territory. All vampires owe him fealty while they are here. He need but say the word, designate a time and place, and Detlaff will be forced to appear.
So this unseen elder, how do we convince him to summon Detlaff?
We must find him first. The elder does not see arrivals unless he absolutely must. But locals, Oriana, for instance. You know, she too is a...
Yeah, figured it out. All right, let's say she gets me in to see the unseen elder. What then?
I don't know. You'll have to improvise, I suppose.
So I'm basically stuck. Either gotta give in to a blackmailer, or fight him.
You know what I would opt for. Should we free Siana and arrange for her to meet with Detlaff, there's a good chance we'll all survive this ordeal. Detlaff included.
Regis, don't mean to put you on the spot, but I gotta know. Say I do decide to fight Detlaff, who'll you stand with?
Should you decide your sword is the sole solution, I shall not stand in your way.
Appreciate it.
Certainly hope so. Now, please tell me, what is it you intend to do?
Crazy as the plan seems, I'll do it. I'll ask Damien about Siana.
You won't make me beg. I knew you wouldn't.
Slow down. Not promising a thing. Just want to get a feel for the situation to start with. Coming with?
Of course. Many hands make light work. Hurry. Damien could be in danger.
Or dead.
You think so? He seemed battle-hardened. More than a few scraps under his belt.
Against humans, not monsters. Lesser vampires would heed a higher vampire's call and commands.
As a rule, they don't.
So how Detlaff sick them on the city?
I told you, he's exceptional. He manages to bend them to his will, control them with his thoughts. They'll continue attacking until he orders them to back down until he dies.
Useless. Claws sliced through steel like through butter.
We must hurry. Each moment's delay means another death.
Armor proved useless. Claws sliced through steel like through butter.
We must hurry. Each moment's delay means another death.
They broke formation, ran.
That scent. It's Damien's blood. He was wounded.
Let's go.
Recognize the vampire.
You killed it! Single-handedly! That harlot's brood slaughtered half my unit!
I see the harlot's brood came close to slaughtering you as well.
Need to withdraw. You and your men. Now.
My duty lies with the city.
Won't help this city by leading your men to the slaughter. Damien, conversation back at the palace, remember? I'll say it again. Your men don't stand a chance.
Tend to the wounded, and prepare to march out.
Doing the right thing. Now listen close. Silver, that's what you want to use against vampires. Your alchemists order them to produce as much vampire oil as they can, churn it out in gallons, then coat your blades with it. Keep an eye out for Alps and Bruxae. The shapely ones resemble women. There one moment, gone the next. Bombs containing silver splinters are a pretty good idea.
Thank you, Witcher. I hope you're worth the coin the Duchess pledged you. And that you'll return with the head of the wretch that did this, skewered on a hook.
Got a different plan.
And what would that be?
All I can say just now is I'm gonna need Sianna.
You know the Duchess's decision. Sianna awaits her trial. In custody.
We know it, but we do not agree with it.
You've that luxury. I do not. I've sworn my loyalty to Her Grace.
Folk are dying. Many more will, because of one.
If Her Grace learns I helped you, my head will roll.
And ours will follow right after it. Yet still we are prepared to take the risk. I fear we waste our time here. Come, Geralt.
Wait. When last I saw Sianna, Her Grace was escorting her to the palace playroom.
Playroom? As in, for children? You sure?
I've served in the Ducal Palace for years. I know its every corner. So yes, I am damn sure.
Playroom? So what, Duchess locks Sianna up in a dollhouse?
Honestly, I've no clue. Look. I've told you what I saw. What you do with it is no concern of mine.
Got it. I'll look into it. You get back to your barracks. Retrace my steps. Path ought to be clear.
And you've our gratitude. You helped us a great deal.
I helped Beauclair. At least I hope I did.
Let's go, Regis.
Here, the playroom's beyond this door.
Rather not have a fist fight with his door. Would you mind?
Not at all.
Thanks.
At your service.
Utter silence. No one here.
We should look around at least.
Nothing under the carpet.
Did you expect something? Apart from the dust swept under there by a lazy chambermaid. Mirror, mirror on the wall. I despise these things.
Miniature tableware. And plush toys. Cute. Wooden duck. Somebody broke its wings off. Nice tune.
Indeed, pleasant. It's a shame the mechanism's damaged.
What the? Found a notebook. Property of Isabelle de Roquefort, court governess. The notes of Sienna and Anna Henrietta's governess when they were little.
I'm not sure it will help, but I suppose there's no harm in leafing through them.
Sienna gave me a drawing today.
Charming.
Of freshly decapitated bodies covered in blood.
Perhaps not so much.
I asked her why ever she would draw such a thing. Her Highness claimed it was a rendering of nightmares which have plagued her for as long as she can remember. Sienna does wake up screaming nearly every night, save when she shares a bed with Honorietta. Curse of the Black Sun. Supposedly girls afflicted by it had horrible dreams. Kind of horrible that made some of them go mad. The girls quarreled today. I must note rather sadly they did not behave as befits future ladies. The incident devolved into fisticuffs. Anna Henrietta was first to strike her sister. Sienna gave back as good as she'd gotten. By the time I separated them, Honorietta had lost two teeth. She ran off to complain to her parents. His Grace the Duke refused to believe my version of events. He laid all the blame on Sienna and vowed to punish the little one harshly. Honorietta did her best to have her sister's sentence commuted, but the Duke and Duchess proved unbending.
Once you're labeled a black sheep, it's so hard to shed that reputation.
Today I accompanied the girls for the first time to the Land of a Thousand Fables. We spent half the day there. First we played with Thumbelina, then with Barbarossa, who proved quite the charmer for a brigand and pirate.
I'm beginning to suspect Isabel de Roquefort wrote in her diary after taking a powerful hallucinogenic. Cannabis rudolaris, for instance, or...
Shh, don't interrupt. I tip my cap to Master Artorius Vigo for his achievement. He has proved he has no equal in the arcane arts.
Wait, Artorius was the court mage here, a specialist in illusions, which means...
Regis, last warning. Stop interrupting or I'll seat you in the corner. The girls told me, if I ever wish to visit alone, I need but crack open the Land of a Thousand Fables and utter out loud the incantation, Expecto Ludum.
A book as the key to an illusion. My, this grows more interesting by the minute.
Mages sent by the Conclave arrived today. They came to examine Sianna. I cannot know what conclusions they drew, but His Grace now seems clearly upset.
Curse of the Black Sun. There's no doubt then that she was diagnosed with the syndrome's symptoms.
Or had that label planted on her. It goes on. I dared ask the Duke what would become of the girl. He did not reply. I tutored the girls in Nilfgaardian today. Sianna applies herself so, though she has great difficulty memorizing new vocabulary. Lady Honorietta seems more gifted in this regard, yet also prone to impish behavior. When she thought me out of earshot, she called me a blood accuser. She and Sianna laughed so hard they almost choked. Blooda is damned, or cursed. What's accuser?
In the melodious tongue of our none-too-friendly neighbors to the south, the word describes the many-petaled flower that blooms in that place we so unmelodiously call the crotch.
This might sound improbable, but maybe, just maybe, Anna Henrietta tossed Sianna into that illusion.
Not impossible. She would be safe there, and isolated. We must see.
Where's that book? Locked. Is it? Let's see. Expecto Ludum. Regis! Land of a Thousand Fables. Incredible. Let's see where this road takes me. An illusion. It's so powerful there's no way to dispel it. That should be interesting.
Let him out!
Voices.
He gobbled up my gingerbread! Now it's my turn to gobble him!
Then you open it. Now, who's this? A lost traveler? You're not supposed to be here, sweetie. Why, you're old. Old and pale. But never worry. A bit of butter, a bit of spice, and you'll make a tasty morsel. As soon as I catch you. Wicked witch. You've heard of her, haven't you? Now, where did you put that key?
Listen, I... How'd you come by a weapon?
It's Prince Charming's. He no longer needs it. Here it is.
Thank you. She'd have begged me for certain if you'd not... Sienna? Is that you?
It's been years, Jack.
Have you come to play?
No, I just want your beans, so you can breathe easy.
Breathe easy? Because you aren't here to play? What's that about?
Jack knows what I mean, so he'll tell me where the beans are as fast as he can. Isn't that right?
Sian, I'm sorry, but I haven't got them.
Oh, something tells me you're lying. Perhaps you wish to play the old games after all, hmm? This little picky went to market. This little picky went home, for instance.
I'm telling the truth. I swear it. Anarieta, she ordered them buried all over so you wouldn't be able to leave.
Where?
I don't know. But Joss, the boy with the thing for wolves, he should know. He sticks his nose in everyone's affairs.
He had better know. Because if not, I'll find you and we'll have ourselves a little talk. Understand? Now shoo! Ah, all right. So why is it you're here?
Searching for my lost childhood. Wound up at Kaer Morhen as a little boy. Don't quite remember how. Never had any toys. Never played any games. What do you think? Why might I be here? It's Detlaf. He's trying to force Anna Henrietta's hand. Wants her to release you. Summoned monsters to attack Beauclair.
Sounds like... But I doubt you came all this way just to bring me up to speed on current events. So get to the point, please.
Isn't it obvious? Offering to be your ally. We both want you out of here. You because you want your freedom back. Me because as soon as you meet with Detlaf, he'll put an end to the chaos in the city.
You exposed me. I landed in prison because of you. Now you come to beg my help, I dare say. My life is full of surprises, isn't it? But normally I'd tell you to sod off. But, from what you say... Folk are dying who have nothing to do with this. Not part of the plan. Detlaf was only to kill those who deserved it. No one else. Fine, Witcher. I accept your offer. Consider us allies. Shake on it.
This place. Tell me something more. It's an illusion, right?
Yes. Created by Artorias Vigo. Anna Henrietta and I would come here to play out scenes from our favorite fables.
Which didn't seem like she was playing.
Magical entropy. Without maintenance, the spell gradually disintegrates over time. It grows wild.
Your sister chose a dangerous place for your prison.
It's deceptive. Provided I don't provoke them, the fairy tale characters don't attack me. But you don't belong here. So you had best be on your watch.
Since you brought it up, the knights Detlaf killed. What exactly did they do to you? Crespi, Duloc, Lacroix, Peyrek Peyrin?
Not a memory I enjoy revisiting, but... I suppose you deserve to know. When my parents disowned me, they ordered those very knights to escort me beyond the duchy's borders. All did so without uttering a single word in my defense.
Like you said, they had their orders.
Mm-hmm. But Crespi was not ordered to beat me unconscious with a horsewhip after my first attempt at escape. And Ulaik had no instructions to deny me food and abuse me. I learned something then. Knights are not so chivalrous when no one's watching.
That explains a lot.
Shocked, aren't you? You must have thought you had me pegged, before bothering to hear my side. Everyone does that.
Curse of the Black Sun. That's why you were banished, right?
Mm-hmm. Twisted princesses, mutants. I'm certain you've heard of us.
Even met one of you, Renfri of Craydon.
And? Was she truly monstrous?
She was cruel, that's certain. But what caused it? The curse or what she went through? Asking myself to this day.
You killed her, didn't you?
Had no choice.
Funny. Mum said the same when she tossed me out of the house.
So, what's with the beams? Mind explaining?
Certainly. That you must gird yourself with patience. There are two ways out of this land. My darling sister blocked one when she tossed me in here. The other's up there, in the clouds. She made it hard, but not impossible to access by concealing the beams.
Still don't understand.
Don't fret, just listen. That boy, that was Jack, of Beanstalk fame. You know the tale?
Jack climbed a gigantic beanstalk to a giant's castle, high up in the clouds.
As we shall do if we can just find those blasted beams. There are three. One red, one blue, one yellow.
Stalk won't sprout from just one?
No, because it must transpire exactly as it did in the tale. Clear now? So we must find Joss. Perhaps he will be able to help us. You lead. Joss can usually be found wandering the glade at the foot of the mount. It's some distance from here, past the witch's house to the right. So, what exactly is happening in the city?
Bloodshed, a massacre, which is why we gotta hurry.
Time flows differently in the Protosphere. We can stay here a week, yet outside, mere minutes will have passed. Watch out! Pixies!
Reminds me of something altogether different.
Care to elaborate?
Rather not.